The Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao is seeking representation in the Anti-Terrorism Council that will dictate who can be arrested for terrorism under the newly signed Anti-Terrorism Act. For more on this, we now have Murad Ebrahim, the Chief Minister of the Bangsamoro Transition Authority. Good morning, Chairman Murad, and thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Morning po. Morning, and thank you for inviting me.
First, explain to us the turnabout, because we know that the Bangsamoro Parliament issued a strong resolution urging the President to veto the new anti-terrorism law, but he still signed it into law. And now, afterward, you issued a statement expressing full support for the measure. So what happened there?
Actually, we deliberated in the BTA, in the Parliament, the issue of this anti-terrorism bill. And we come up with the conclusion that we will request the President to veto the bill on the ground that we want to have a more comprehensive discussion by the Congress on certain issues. We are more particularly concerned. One is on the issue of the definition of terrorism. We feel that it has to be clearly defined. Second is on this method of surveillance. So we see that there must be a better understanding of how would the authorities will be allowed to conduct surveillance of any people, suspect people. And then we are also concerned on the power of the Anti-Terrorism Council to order an arrest. With this, the conclusion of the Parliament is to request the President to veto the bill. And we submitted actually our request to the President on July 2. We are not very sure because whether it was really reached the President, but July 3, he signed the anti-terrorist bill.
So what happened to the position that you took? Because I'm looking actually for an explanation of the turnabout. Yes. So previously you were opposed to this. I'm talking about the resolution coming from the Parliament, and now you're fully supporting this. So what happened to the position that you took against these three main issues that you have just cited?
You know, our concern, the issues we are concerned is not our personal concern or the government concern. It is the concern of our constituent. So what is important for us is to, kasi ang concern ng ating mga constituent ay hindi mangyayari yung kinatatakutan nila. So that is why upon signing of the bill, ang tingin namin sa aming panic, because we are in the government, then we are bound to abide by the law, as it is already a law. It is no longer a bill to be discussed. So dahil doon, we issued also a statement. We respect the decision of the President. And being in the government, the Bangsamoro Transition Government will support the implementation of the law. And then, but on the other hand, we are requesting for the sake of our constituent na baka pwedeng maging member kami, official member kami dyan sa council, at least we can represent our people. Na kung yung mga concern nila, then we can represent it in the council. So yun ang official statement namin.
Okay, so how exactly do you intend to be represented at the ATC? Because the ATC is composed of cabinet level officials, but I know that there are at least 15 support agencies for the ATC.
Yeah.
Are you looking at that? Yung one of the 15 agencies?
What we are looking for initially is to be, to have continuing engagement with the national government on this issue, and then maybe we can discuss how we can be represented in the council of the AT law.
But isn't this an afterthought coming from the national government, when in fact they should have considered the representation of the people of the Bangsamoro, because primarily they are the ones to be affected by whatever means this new law will be implemented?
Yeah, that is exactly the reason why we want to be represented. And if you don't mind, I'd like to read my statement issued on July 3. This is a statement on July 3, 2020, President Rodrigo Duterte signed the Anti-Terrorism Act of 2020 into law. The Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao, being a government itself, fully respects this decision of the president.
Okay.
There is no one way of addressing threats of terrorism, which is an evolving discourse globally. The BARM is open to engage the national government on preparedness against the vicious phenomenon as we collectively explore new potential approaches to holistically protect our people from the menace of terrorism.
Okay.
The engagement can start with the Bangsamoro having representation in the Anti-Terrorism Council.
Chairman Murad, in the first place, were you, for example, or members of the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao, were you consulted while lawmakers were crafting the anti-terrorism law?
Wala pong official consultation sa amin. We were not consulted by Congress or Senate.
So never by the senators or by the House members?
Wala po.
So what does that tell you?
That is why we really feel concerned. Yung mga constituent namin ang talagang nagpan na very apprehensive sila. Na kasi the experience of our people during the martial law time and the height of the conflict is tells them na talagang there's a danger in the, there is risk in this terrorism bill.
Okay, I know that you already issued a statement expressing full support for the anti-terrorism law, despite the reservations that you also made before the president signed this into law. But didn't you also consider the other option to somehow, for example, perhaps question certain provisions of the anti-terrorism law before the Supreme Court? Because I assume that the issues that you raise are very serious and you're very much concerned about this.
Yes, yes. But then I know that there are already personalities who already went to the Supreme Court. On our side, siguro, we just hope to just engage the national government. Hopefully now we can still produce some result na ma-address yung concern namin. Because we feel it also not very advisable as part of the government and going to the Supreme Court complaining against the national government. That would be it is. We choose to have it bilateral relationship. We take it over.
Okay, I understand that. Especially given the status of the Bangsamoro government now, you're still the Bangsamoro Transition Authority, so everything is in the process of being completed. So your first election will happen, of course, in 2022. Now, my next question is this. Given the seriousness of the issues that you raise, for example, surveillance, the immense powers of the ATC, don't you think that assuming that this particular law is abused, won't this somehow set back the gains so far of a political settlement that is now being implemented under the BOL?
Well, sa panig naman ng Office of the President, they have been assuring us na hindi ito magiging ban sa gabar sa ating itong Bangsamoro. So it remains to be seen kung ano, but that is why ang tingin lang namin ngayon is we should at this point in time we are in contact with the DND secretary, we are also in contact with the Office of the President, and Secretary Galvis also, and then we will be discussing it also in the intergovernmental relations.
Okay. Now another issue is the possibility that the abusive implementation of certain provisions of this ATC might actually lead to the worsening of discrimination against our Muslim brothers and sisters, which is already happening now, and which of course everyone is trying to fix or to address. But now you have a very strong law which might be misused against the Bangsamoro. What do you say to that?
Well, actually, all this depends really on the authorities, because what is really very worrying is if the authorities will abuse the implementation of the law. So yun ang nakikita namin. If it will not be abused, ay wala namang kaming kwan. We can, and then being in the government, if we will be involved in the implementation, siguro ma-protekan namin yung mga walang kasalanan. As far as though yung mga kwan, we know that there are people, Bangsamoro people, who are being carried into this terroristic phenomenon. And so wala naman tayong problema doon, because on us, we have been fighting these terrorists. We have been not only through by words, but we are fighting them actually in the ground. Mm. So wala naman problema doon.
But in the first place, given your experience as a former rebel, and now you're running a government, a regional government, given your experience in dealing with violent extremists now, does the country actually need this anti-terrorism law at this time?
Well, actually, sa aming panig, we support the creation of a law that will prevent us from that will be used to fight against this terrorism, because we really condemn this terrorism. We don't. We have been, as I have said, we have been fighting them. But then, yun nga lang na we have to protect that the law will not be abused in its implementation.
Okay. Finally, Chairman Murad, is there also concern on your part that you might also somehow lose a bit of the support that you enjoy now from your people because of this change in tone? Because primarily the issues that you raised were also representative of the sentiments or the concerns of your own people about the possible abuses under the new anti-terrorism law. And now there's full support coming from the leadership, including yourself. Don't you think this might also affect their support for you?
We are engaging our people now. Currently, we have been starting engaging with them. And then, in fact, we've been calling meetings after this. And then we see that the only remedy, if we can have an effective role in the council, anti-terrorism council, I think that would give at least send a message to our people that we still have a chance, we have still the authority, the chance to defend their rights.
Okay, Chairman Murad Ebrahim, thank you very much for joining us this morning, sir.
Thank you very much, Christian. Thank you for inviting me, and good morning to everyone.